represent the people whose rights are infringed. That means the judge has the right to calculate the damage from the 5,000 to the 300,000 RMB.
So they finally have a discretion, which they didn't have really before, so they can go ahead and I think that's the key factor. Whenever in the law office that I work at, always the foreign companies are saying, well, what can we get as far as damages are concerned? Or what, you know, or anybody who comes in with the rights infringed, what can we get as far as damages are concerned? I try to say to them, hey, it's very difficult to get damages now in China.
Yeah.
But under the new law, it will be different because the judge will have discretion, even if he doesn't find damages, which is sometimes very difficult to do, because to calculate the economic damages are very difficult. Then he has a discretion to use this fining system, and I think that the damages can go up to 500,000 RMB in that discretion too. Yeah.
So it does seem that the Second Amendment has greatly improved China's patent law.
Absolutely.
Yes. Well, thank you very much for speaking to us.
Pleasure.
In China, more and more laws have been made and amended to become in line with international standard and practice. But lawmaking is only the first step towards building a true legal society in China. Thank you for staying with us for this edition of Dialogue. I'm Jiabing in Beijing. Do send us a comment on the program. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.